kasama po natin, of course, once again, ang ating Sufia, talaga namang love na love, ano, and very informative, na si Michelle Viesca, na isa pong personal effectiveness coach and corporate communications guru. Good morning, Michelle!
Morning.
Morning po, Ma'am Sheila.
Happy Wellness Wednesday.
Good morning.
Happy Wellness Wednesday po.
Good morning.
And good morning, Kuya, to all the viewers. Napakaganda ng ating topic ngayon, ladies.
Napapanahon ito.
Sige. Yes.
Ano ba ang ating pag-uusapan?
Lalo na ngayon, ang pag-uusapan natin, why leadership communication matters. And everyone has to be equipped with that. Whether you are the leader, the one supporting the leader, the one who's aspiring for that leadership position.
And it's ano po ba yung mga factors that we should consider na to be able to discern that the communication from a leadership is successful.
Okay. Well, alam natin kung ano yung downside pag hindi natin na-observe to. But let's talk about those items of significance. So leadership communication, it is definitely a skill. Kahit positional leader ka, you are new in the company, you are new in the organization, or permission leader, people want you to be there, or pinnacle leader, na nandyan ka na sa taas, you have to be able to sustain this kind of successful communication with the people you're leading. Kasi it will determine kung susulong ba kayo, or magsastagnate, or overall magpifail. So in a nutshell, it is what helps and allows societies, communities to function on a day-to-day basis, to flourish. And it allows the leaders to establish respect, saka yung proper dynamics among the people that he's leading. At maraming klase, maraming style ng leadership communication, hindi lang iisa. So usually a leader who has the exposure to the right environment, to the right intervention, at nakakapag-introspect siya kung ano talaga yung gustong marinig sa kanya, he's able to adjust. Bottom line, whatever communication this leader should have or should be able to articulate must lead to people getting more motivated, you know, getting more clear when it comes to their directions. Kaya yung communication is in the form of an advice or recommendation or campaign. So yun yung gusto natin. It builds. It fosters harmony, productivity, clarity of thinking among those who are listening.
Sa isang leader po ba, kailangan po ba na, in terms of communication, no, marunong po ba siya, kailangan marunong lang ba siya mag-Ingles o kailangan okay lang ba yung marunong din siya mag-Tagalog? And then secondly is kung paano siya magsalita, no, yung tone ng pananalita niya, kailangan po ba yung malumanay, kailangan po ba yung firm siya, paano po ba natin masasabi na okay yung communication skills ng isang leader po?
Well, maraming characteristics, maraming strong qualities yung leadership communication. But for us to clear, tingnan natin sa tatlong R. So yung nauuna, it has to be resonant. So whether the leader uses the vernacular, o mag-English siya, or mag-Taglish siya, the point there is no matter how right you are in your grammatical structure, or the tonality, or how accurate your pronunciation, if you're not able to conform to the expectations of the people you are leading, medyo hindi magiging resonant yung sinasabi mo. So you want to be able to relate to them. Kasi relatability is a very strong point of resonant communication. Hindi yung pag narinig ka nila, sasabihin na ano daw, ba't ganun? Ano nangyari? Right? They would feel, wow, this is our leader. This is the person we would like to be there. Wow, thank you that you are a leader. We are thankful that you are the one who's who's in that position, who we are following. And then secondly, of course, it has to be responsive. Communication at that level should not be reactive. So, yun natin ma-define how responsive communication is. Nagninilay-nilay muna yung leader. Nakikinig siya, whether it's from feedback or discernment. Kailangan huminto muna. Wag basta-basta lang susugod or magsasalita. Because the reality is that not everything in your head is meant to be said. Lalo na pag nandyan ka na sa role na yan.
True.
Hindi sa lahat ng pagkakataon kung ano yung iniisip mo, tama. And this is also, unfortunately, the reason silence from those who don't really have much to say is given much credit. Kasi silence is the notion that the person is listening, the person is discerning. So yung mga marunong makinig, marunong mag-gather ng feedback, if they're not able to hold back and not able to communicate in a manner that's timely and moderated, medyo hindi responsive yung naririnig natin sa kanila. Hindi nila nade-detach kung ano yung masyadong nararamdaman nila. And matters of importance are clouded by personal feelings. And then the third one is responsible.
Go ahead po.
Ay, yeah, sige.
Responsible.
Oo. Yung pangatlo lang, responsible.
Mm-mm.
So, itong pangatlong to is as important as all the others because as crucial as the message of the leader is the consideration of what will most benefit the people he's leading. So, hindi lang importante na alam mo yung sinasabi mo, na tama yung sinasabi mo. Because, you know, at the end of the day, if that's if those are the only things that you're holding on to, no matter how right you are, you can still be wrong. Kasi you're responsible not only for yourself, for your message, but for the considerations of people you are leading and the people who are observing you. Maraming critics.
Mm-hmm.
It's still not the critics that count, but the people in the field, the leader, who's working. But if you're not mindful, if you don't take responsibility for what you're saying in favor of those who are listening, mamamali ka rin dyan.
Mm-hmm. It can make
so
or break
three
you. Mabuti na mention nyo yun.
Communication at that level, resonant, yes. Responsible, uh-oh. Responsive.
Yun, ha? Perfect. Yung palang mga 3 hours natin. Mabuti na mention yung may Sheila kanina, yung feelings, ano? When it comes to communicating, ano, tayo ginagamit natin yung emotions natin to convey what we want to say. Syempre, we're talking to people, not to robots, ano? Pero when it comes to that, when and when not to use your emotions kapag nagko-communicate ka as a leader? Kasi syempre, aminin natin, tao din naman sila, may nararamdaman din sila, na-frustrate, nagagalit, na-excite, diba? Tulad nating lahat, ano? Pero kailan mo dapat na magkaroon ka ng filter para hindi, you know, kasi ang emotions mo, diba, when it comes to communicating with others, it can make or break you, especially kapag padalos-dalos ka. Pero ano yung mga circumstances na dapat para wait lang?
Mm-hmm.
Parang step back muna ako kasi masyado akong overwhelmed sa mga kaganapan sa aking kapaligiran.
Yes. Yes. Well, that's a good point, Kikay, kasi kailangan naman ng leader, authenticity. No matter what communication style this leader has, pwede nating pagbigyan. But if there's no authenticity, ramdam natin talaga yan. And the leader can be sorely misjudged, can lose the votes. Pag medyo iba yung timpla natin na hindi totoo, medyo may kaplastikan, medyo scripted. Okay? So while authenticity is a big consideration, in many situations when the leader has to communicate, emotionality unfortunately has no role. Kung ano yung nararamdaman niya is not a big consideration as far as the listeners are concerned. Sensibility should be the rule of thumb. Ano yung difference Emotionality is your ability to express your emotions, hinay-hinay ka dyan. Sensibility is your ability to understand how others are feeling about the situation, about the communication, about the issue at hand. So, while you have to be contextual, at marami ka namang pwedeng sabihin na align dun sa mga nangyayari within context ka naman, kailangan babantayan mo how your emotions can potentially harm the messaging. Kasi ang resulta niyan, it can affect the collaboration or dynamics ng mga sumusuporta sa'yo. And syempre, maraming mata-turn off. Diba parang it counters the point na kailangan kang maging authentic. But then that's when we have to differentiate emotionality and sensibility. Aligned with your message is the consideration of the listener's point of view.
And Miss Sheila, I also believe ano na yung communication is not just about talking, no? And a leader must be a good listener as well, 'di ba? Para maging mabuti siyang or effective na communicator. Tama po ba, Miss Sheila?
Tama. That's so on point, Angel, kasi there are three reasons leadership communication fails. Unang-una dyan, the leader's inability to listen. Kailangan ramdam mo kung ano yung gusto ng tao from you. At ramdam mo rin kung ano yung gusto mong ipahiwatig, iparating sa mga pinamumunuan mo, sa mga sumusunod sa'yo, sa mga gustong bumoto sa'yo. So it's crucial that the leader knows when to pause and ponder para i-gather mo kung ano yung mga elements in that situation. Yung pangalawa naman is your ability to take in kung ano yung feedback without interrupting. Kasi kung nakikinig ka nga, pero salita ka naman ng salita kasi nasanay ka na ikaw yung person in command, eh hindi mo rin madidiscern yung value ng mga nasasagap mo at yung mga nasabi sa'yo. Because what you are supposed to listen to are not always verbally articulated, eh. Sa body language nila, di ba? Sa feeling mo, ano ba yung what's in the air? Parang may mali. So, titimplahin mo yan.
Now, so, parang...
Of course, it's...
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yung pangatlo, of course, is... yung tendency of the leader to be emotional. Yun yung tatlo. So if we take this into account, medyo mas mapaghuhusay natin, mas mapaghuhusay ng leader how is able to communicate. Pero number one dyan is what Angel was able to point out, ability to listen.
Listening, ha? Not hearing. Kasi,
iba kasi labas sa tenga.
Oo, di ba? Kunyari, nakikinig pero hindi naman talaga
ina-absorb. But you don't understand.
Pero which leads me to my question, ano, in that issue. Ano po bang maaaring gawin ng isang leader to earn the trust of the people to listen to him naman? Kasi, like, for example, no, in a corporate setting or in any setting, ano, kapag may changes in leadership, parang merong not just awkwardness but you know trust issues between the people and that new tama ka dyan, Kika, no? And that new leader, paano po ba gagawin ng isang leader na ma-earn yung trust ng kanyang people at mapakinggan naman siya once and for all, no, na hindi muna siya i-judge base doon sa tingin ng kanyang mga tao, Ms. Sheila?
Yeah. Well, banggit mo yung change in leadership. So sa study ng change leadership, talagang it always goes out. Lagi nag-uumpisa na excited lahat kasi may bago. O galing siya sa ganung industry, ganung kumpanya. Ah, pareho kami ng apelido, may pareho kaming kakilala. And then you realize, iba pala tong taong to. And you recognize na marami siyang contributions. And most likely, may iba dun sa nakasanayan nyo. And so, most of the time, when there's a change in leadership, umpisa ng high point, tapos pabagsak. And so the role of the leader really, when it comes to listening, is so valuable. Makikinig ka talaga. And that's accurate. It takes heart to listen. That's why it's more, it's harder to listen. It's more painful to listen kasi you have to give your full attention. Kailangan nag-iisip ka when you're truly listening. Pag nagsasalita ka, pwede ka magsalita kahit di ka nag-iisip. Right? Articulate mo lang kasi you're so used to it. Sanay ka na sa sitwasyon. But in order to listen to what others are saying, you have to give them their full, your full attention. So whether it's in a one-on-one session or forum or meeting, town hall, kailangan maging maging open yung leader to the suggestions of others. And truly discern, itimbangin niya kung ano yung sinasabi ng iba-ibang grupo, lalo na if it's going to enter an organization na may silo na. Silo mentality, may kanya-kanya na silang hugot at pinanggagalingan. So, sometimes, it's good to also recognize yung mga permission leaders within the group. They are not in the position of power. Hindi sila manager, hindi sila supervisor. Pero sila yung pinakikinggan ng lahat. Para mas matimpla ng leader kung ano yung nangyayari in the on the ground. So, ganun din naman sa ating mga kandidato. Pinakikinggan nila yung mga leaders ng mga different groups, organizations, communities. Pero hindi nila tinitake for granted na yung sa kanilang campaign, mga common tao, mga walang negosyo, yung mga usual na voters, pinakikinggan nila.
Sa inyo po ba, Ma'am Sheila, marami po ba ang lumalapit sa inyo para po magkaroon sila ng communication workshop or communication training, no? Especially po yung mga young leaders po na who wanted also to do long-term goals, may mga long-term goals sila in politics o kaya sa mga offices nila. Marami po bang lumalapit sa inyo na, syempre mga bata pa, to be able to develop their communication skills, no? Ano-ano po yung mga training na binibigay niyo po sa kandidato?
Asking talk we started a long time ago, over 2 decades na yung company, addressing communication concerns in organizations, you know, among individuals and groups. At up to now, whether it's leadership training or personal effectiveness, cross culture, talagang ang baseline, it's effective communication. And people recognize, leaders recognize that poor communication skills can be an organizational poison. So everything that we teach at Talk Shop is communication based. Kasi that's how you're able to articulate your competence, your good intentions, your kindness. Because your audience, the people you're leading, are not mind readers. So if you're not able to communicate well, it can stifle the business, yung pagpapalakad mo, yung impression ng tao sa'yo, lalo na pag nag-uumpisa ka pa lang dyan. Those who come to us, amazingly enough, are leaders who are already good at communication. And the irony of this is that, hindi sila satisfied sa performance nila or sa overall results ng kanilang ginagawa. Those who are not, unfortunately, kung sino pa yung hindi marunong mag-communicate, sila pa yung walang awareness na hindi sila nakaka-reach out dun sa mga taong kausap nila. Well, it's not a generalization. May mga sensibility issues, but generally from our experience, ang ayaw kumuha ng communication, thinking that it's such a basic skill, alam na nila, are those who don't know how to communicate well.
Right. Tsaka I think kapag leader ka, dapat transparent ka din, no, in all aspects of your leadership, no. Kung halimbawa ikaw ay nasa corporate setting, dapat transparent ka dun sa mga ginagawa ng org ninyo. And ganun din kapag, syempre, pag leader ka ng isang bansa,
being transparency, di ba? All the more that you need transparency when it comes to transactions, di ba, yung mga government transaction, para walang allegation, accusations, yung mga ganun, di ba? Corruption mm-hmm. allegations rather, di ba, Michelle? Mm-hmm.
True. Yeah, definitely, lack of transparency leads to inadequate communication because there's a lot that you're holding back. How can you be resonant in your leadership kung hindi alam ng tao kung ano yung pinagsasabi mo? If they have to piece together the puzzle, di ba? Kailangan pag nilatag mo, malinaw na sa kanila. And that clarity of thinking is grounded on honesty, you know, that allows you to give adequate information to the people you're leading. Kasi kung wala yan, magiging inconsistent yung service na binibigay niya sa tao, yung nangyayaring productivity within your organization at yung expectations mo rin sa iba, hindi align dun sa vision of the organization.
Mm-hmm. Kaya good nang point. Mama Sheila, hindi ba nadadaya din yung honesty tsaka authenticity when it comes to communication? Dahil madalas may mga writers na yung mga ano natin, yung mga politicians natin, 'di ba?
Parang pinag-aralan na.
Oo, parang may mga writers na sila tapos yun na lang babasahin na lang nila, yun na lang yung i-communicate nila. So paano po pag ganun?
Yeah. So sensibility definitely is something that needs to be considered not only by the leaders but by those who are listening to them as well. Kasi mararamdaman mo eh kung scripted to. At kung scripted man yan, is this the real message that this leader represents or wants to communicate? Siyempre, kinoconsider natin if a person is leading an organization, a community, or especially a country kung may desire siya na national scope ang leadership niya, it can be very stressful. So, kukuha siya ng mga writers para magsulat para sa kanya, but i-review niya yun, at saka message pa rin niya yun. Hindi yung script pagkakuha niya sa kanya babasahin at malalaman niya kinopya dito, kinopya doon. Diba? It's
copy-paste, nako.
Oo, at hindi magiging resonant yun kasi hindi niya ramdam. A leader who is effective in communication is one with his message. Hindi siya nagsasalita dito tapos niya. Diba? You know that what he's communicating is coming from his heart. Kung sinulat man niya ng ibang tao, nakulong man niya siya sa ibang tao, alam mo na yun pa rin yung mensahe niya. So, the more the leader is able to internalize kung ano yung sinasabi niya, the better he gets at being authentic. By being authentic and honest, hindi natin sinasabi na on the spot pag may sinabi to tama. Hindi, it still has to be rehearsed. Kasi kasi iba yung iniisip mo, iba yung sinasabi mo sa isang tao. And once you're facing a much bigger group, minsan iba na yung nagiging translation, right? Kasi marami ng factors in place, eh. Lalo na dun sa mga leaders hindi naman nila what do you call this? Comfort zone ang magsalita extensively in front of a big group.
Oo. Gusto ko yung topic
kasi
na to.
di ba, Miss Sheila, given naman na even the highest position in the land, talagang may mga comm strategist yung mga yan. But it's how this leader works with the team eh. Di ba? Paano nila ma-integrate yung sarili niya doon sa mga speeches. But my question is, last question na po, Miss Sheila, no, na meron po bang instances na may mga leaders na okay naman sila when it comes to critical thinking, mga decision making, but when it comes to communicating to their team or to the people o sa mandate nila, medyo okay. Do you consider it a failed leadership or this is something that you can work it out naman in the long run?
Yes, definitely. Everyone can be a good communicator because in communication, our most powerful tool is our ability to think. Basta may kakayahan kang mag-isip, kaya mong mag-communicate. But it takes practice. There are tools and strategies that one can learn. Because when you articulate what's in your head, may mga ipapractice ka when it comes to your ability to pause, diba? Yung tonality mo, yung phrasing mo, tapos even the pronunciation has to be considered. The people listening to you will not be nitpicking. They will evaluate your effective communication overall. Kaya kailangan paghandaan ito, kailangan pag-aralan. It's not automatic that if you are a good thinker, if you're a critical thinker, you can communicate well. Because there are strategies when it comes to effective communication. Lalo na in an environment which is stressful, na kailangan mag-step back yung leader. Kailangan i-assess niya kung paano siya makaka-relate better so that whatever he is communicating is resonant and relevant at the same time. You want to be able to establish
well
rapport.
Very well said. Oo. Gusto topic na yung ni Sheila. Oo.
Yes, Hikai. Yes, at tulad ng ginagawa natin, di ba? Conversational. You're not talking at your people. You're not in a monologue. You are in a conversation. No matter how big the group or how many there are to you, they have to feel that they are in a one-on-one conversation with you. Imagine, napakadami mong pagninilay-nilayan, di ba? May message ka na, nagsasabihin ka pa, tapos pagdating sa kanila, may feedback ka, and not everyone who is there will be pleased with you. So, tanggapin mo rin yan. Otherwise, your communication style will be reactive. Kasi it's stressful if you take into account lahat ng nararamdaman ng nakapaligid sa'yo. It's a tough call. But you rise to the occasion if you want to be a leader for all. And along the way, pag-aralan mong mabuti kung ano yung mali mong gawa, kung ano yung tama, kung ano yung pwede pang mas itama. There's always room for improvement when it comes to leadership communication.
Very well said. Kaya kung gusto nyo talagang pag-aralan na on how to communicate effectively, leader man kayo o hindi, di ba? Alam nyo na kung sinong kukontakin. Kaya may Sheila, napapanahon talaga ito. Gusto ko yung topic natin today. Na-excite ako dyan. Para sa ating mga kasangbahay, sa ating mga viewers who want to learn more on how to communicate effectively, lalong-lalo na syempre on those who want to enhance yung kanilang leadership skills. How do they get in touch with you? And ano po ba yung inyong mga social media pages?
Thank you very much, Kikai. Before I say that, I would like to say from the bottom of my heart, salamat ng marami ladies. Because every time we have this session, it's, exchange tayo ng views and insights. And your intelligent questions really inspire me to deliver kung ano yung tamang message. So it's always a great conversation with you, ladies. I learn a lot from how you handle this communication process, and I'm surely inspired by your intelligence in the way you answer questions at saka pag may mga insights kayong naibibigay. Salamat ng marami. And thank you, Kuya, for the opportunity.
Thank you po.
Thank you.
Thank you for bringing up an interesting topic.
Salamat. And those who want to be as comfortable as these ladies are when it comes to hosting, leading the conversation, asking the right questions, initiating the discussion, they can get in touch with us at TalkShop, www.talkshop.ph. The numbers they can call are 0917-877-5588, 0917-894-5588. If you want to reach us on our social media pages, it's via Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn under TalkShop.ph, Sheila Viesca, or TalkShop Consultancy. Drop us a line, give us a call for coaching sessions or assessment of your communication and leadership requirements.
Thank you so much,
Ms.
Sheila. And of
Ma'am
course,
Sheila,
congratulations sa pag-release ng iyong book.
Congrats, Sheila.
It's been published. Thank you. It's been published some years back, pero now it's on. It's going to be on Amazon. And definitely, you're one of the first ladies I'll be sending the material to.
Oh,
but now.
Bongga. I-add to cart nyo yan. Ha? Maganda yan. Maganda yung libro na yan. Thank you so much, Michela. Next time po ulit. Happy Wellness
Happy
Wednesday.
Happy Wellness Wednesday.
Happy Wellness Wednesday. Thank you, Kikai, Angel, Mina. Hello to everyone there at UNTV.
Thank you so much.